Last week on The Next Life, Jonathan discovers the Bambu Lab X1 Carbon, but finds that there are some unexpected surprises.
All right, where were we?
Oh, that's right. It takes forever to get going. Okay, great. So a week has passed since the last video. The filament is on a plastic spool. It's loaded up. We press print on this beautiful touchscreen, and we wait. A lot. This is another one that came as a surprise to me, even though I'd heard Stefan at CNC Kitchen talk about it on his fantastic Melt Zone podcast. This thing takes a long time to get going. And when I heard Stefan say that, I thought he meant like 3 or 4 minutes. I mean, I'm no stranger to danger when it comes to waiting for prints to start. I mean, my Voron 2.4 up there has a 350 by 350 millimeter aluminum plate, and that's pretty big, and it can take a few minutes to heat up all the way. But this thing literally takes 7 to 10 minutes to actually start printing. 10 minutes, that's insane. I guess I don't criticize them for it because, quite frankly, once it does start printing, the first layer is absolutely perfect, every time. And yeah, Bambu Lab listened to user feedback and gave users the option at the start of every print to opt out of some parts of that print start sequence. And in all fairness and honesty, I guess I'd rather wait 7 minutes for the print to start, knowing that it will work perfectly the first time, rather than have to monitor the print for the first 20 minutes, or worse yet, have a large percentage of my prints fail on the first layer and then need to be restarted. It's just 7 to 10 minutes. It's smart, like really smart. Okay, I know. We're already into the second video in this series and I still haven't even gotten this thing printing. Now you know how that startup sequence feels. But in all seriousness, once I did get this thing printing, I immediately had a really unique experience that I just had to share with all of you. It was the kind of experience that makes you realize that you are dealing with a higher and significant form of intelligence. Like when you look into an animal's eyes and you go, "Oh wow, this thing gets it." Here's what happened. As you know, the Bambu Lab printers are really fast, and that means that they generate a lot of force. They do, after all, have 20 meter cubed acceleration, and as we know, force equals mass times acceleration. As you may also know, I work in a cramped office in the city center, at least until my Patreon hopefully gains enough supporters and I can afford to move out of here, and that means that I have a flimsy folding desk behind me. Now, after setting up the Bambu Lab X1 Carbon, I immediately realized just how much it was shaking the table. And so in the middle of the print, I took one of my lighting tripods and propped it under the table to give it some extra support. Within seconds, a notification popped up on the screen telling me that the Y-axis, the very axis that I had just put the support in front of, had changed resonance frequency since the beginning of the print, and that I should calibrate it at the beginning of the next print. What? This thing is so smart, it literally is analyzing and measuring the resonance frequencies for all of its axes, I think, in real time as it's printing. Dude. And this is just a small taste of how clever this machine really is. If you use Bambu brand filament, it knows what filament you've put in the rollers in the AMS. It knows which plate is installed on the heat bed and if it's installed correctly, and it alerts you if that plate doesn't match the one that you set in the slicer. I'm pretty sure it knows what I did last summer. The point is, this printer is a far cry from my Prusa's 8-bit board, and it uses all the information it collects to protect you from yourself and make your printing experience easier and more frustration-free. And aside from all the hype about fast printing, the awesome fit, finish, and user experience, the ability to print all kinds of materials, and the insanely low price relative to other machines of its class, all of which you already knew about, that is one of the lesser known sleeper features that really makes a huge difference in the user experience. The filter isn't what you think. Now, one little thing that did kind of annoy me is discovering that the carbon filter in there isn't exactly what you think. Bambu is pushing the X1 Carbon as their flagship, the printer capable of printing anything from ABS to polycarbonate out of the box. And so when you read that one of the differences between the X1 carbon and the X1 is the activated carbon filter, which they advertise as filtering out volatile organic compounds, you tend to assume that the printer is going to, you know, filter. But what I discovered, which you'd really only know if you specifically looked on their website and checked under which category they list the filter, is that this isn't for filtering the air in the chamber, but rather it's for filtering the exhaust from the printer. And I mean, that's fine as long as it's actually doing that. But in the default profiles for things like ABS or ASA, Bambu Slicer, which as I said before, is really clever about just doing things like reminding you to use the right build surface, does not integrate the chamber fan at all. In fact, even if you dig into the filament profile where there are all sorts of cooling settings, there's nothing about the chamber fan to be found. In fact, the only way that I've found so far to activate the chamber fan manually while the printer is printing, if you want to filter, is to do it on the screen or manually in the software. And I've even seen a lot of users that are printing internal third-party filters that filter the air inside without actually venting it out. Now, honestly, I really don't like that solution because I feel like it goes against the entire ethos of what Bambu is trying to accomplish with their rigorously tested, perfected, and done-for-you profiles. And I definitely don't think that it's a good idea to cram extra stuff into the printer with warnings like this one in the bottom. Fortunately, this is one thing that Bambu Lab can easily fix with a software update. And one more idea and area where their walled garden approach, which I promise I'm going to get to in just a minute, can really shine. Because you see, Bambu Slicer is really only ever going to be used with their printers and a handful of other ones that they've added, like the Vorons, which they know the exact specs of. And that means that if they want to, they can build in specific settings right into the profiles for things like ABS. They could, for example, set it up so that anytime you select ABS or another material with a lot of VOCs, the machine automatically adds a 5-minute filtration stage to the end of the print, where the screen will remind you in bright red not to open the door until it finishes exhausting the VOCs through the carbon filter. Or, given that Bambu Lab only offers this fan for the X1 carbon, they could simply do a bunch of tests in-house to determine at what fan speed or temperature the chamber fan is able to operate without warping each different type of material. Though, I guess, of course, it's gonna vary from manufacturer to manufacturer. But then they could simply put those into the profiles for the X1C only. Now, I'm sure Bambu will improve this over time, and that's precisely why they send review units out to people like myself for feedback. But for us end users out there, just remember that in the meantime, if you want to actually use the carbon filter, you need to remember to turn it on manually in the software or on the touchscreen. Which brings us to my final and perhaps most important point. It's a walled garden. Look, I get it. Bambu Lab has created what I honestly believe is a best-in-class product here. You've heard this from every other creator who has one, and yeah, I agree. This thing is light years ahead of the competition. And I think that they, like Apple, would argue that this was made possible only by creating a complete ecosystem from soup to nuts. They make the printer, they make the hot end, they make the material switcher, they make the software, they make the filament, they make the replacement parts. At least for now. And just like Apple, with Apple Silicon and macOS, they've been able to achieve significantly better performance because the hardware and the software are designed to work in perfect harmony, without needing to waste engineering resources designing for many different models or edge cases, like user upgrades or tons of different hardware variations, like something like Android. Now, I fully appreciate that. But it also means that for the time being, you are 100% dependent on them for each and every part of the equation, even at the expense of repairability, as many have noted, but also customizability. So if, for example, you want to use another slicer, such as Prusa Slicer or Cura, or you want to use different software like Octoprint for monitoring your prints and doing time lapses and octolapses, well, you're out of luck. And don't expect to see any CHT nozzles or Revo Obsidian nozzles or any of that stuff come out for Bambu products anytime soon. In fact, even the build plates have a proprietary identifier in them, so companies like Wham Bam have fortunately reverse engineered it but it has limited the amount of products that are available for this printer despite how popular it is. But it doesn't necessarily have to be this way. I mean, Bambu Lab could still maintain complete control over their product and ecosystem, but open certain parts of it up to third-party innovation, similar to how Apple has the Made for iPhone certification program for hardware, and of course, the App Store for software. Personally, I'd love to see CHT nozzles and all different kinds of build plates on the hardware side. I'd love to see my favorite filament manufacturers implementing those awesome RFID chips that are Bambu Lab certified to work with the AMS on the filament side. And I'd be thrilled to see an app store where I could download approved third-party plugins like Exclude Object or Octolapse or Obico and so on. And yet, at the end of the day, this product is still really, really awesome. I mean, this would be a serious win-win for Bambu. They would get to maintain the top-to-bottom control of their product that gives them this tremendous edge, and they would also benefit from others innovating on their platform. After all, it does seem to be working for Apple, who's the world's most valuable technology company and has the highest market share of any smartphone manufacturer in the world. Apple's products, from iPad to iPhone to MacBook, all boast the highest consumer satisfaction in each of their respective categories. And I mean, I love Apple products. From the Apple Watch to iPad, iMac, iPhone, Apple TV, and just about anything else they want to sell me. Personally, I've been living happily in the walled garden for over a decade now. So unless and until Bambu Lab opens up parts of their hardware and software for third parties to play ball, I think you really have to ask yourself, how much do you really care about things like third-party software, open source hardware, and user customizability if they come at the expense of the product's performance and quality? Which is really the same question I've always had with Apple products. Oh, hey, editing Jonathan here. So last week I said that the thing I hated the most about the X1 Carbon was the cool plate and needing to use glue sticks and the fact that there was no textured surface provided. Well, fortunately, the good folks at Wham Bam reached out and let me know that they had already developed a PEX flexible build plate for the X1 Carbon, which works with the LiDAR, works with the QR code, and is just a plug and play upgrade that people are raving about. So Wham Bam was kind enough to sponsor this episode to let you all know not only about their awesome build plate system for the X1 Carbon, but also their full line of flexible PEX build plates for pretty much every 3D printer out there. Wham Bam is unique in that they have their own material called PEX, which is designed to work with every single material, creating an awesome first layer adhesion without any need for a glue stick, except it does stick too well to PETG, so you will need glue stick to make it stick less well. People rave about Wham Bam's products. I'm really excited to be using them as well. And I want to thank Wham Bam for helping me invest in equipment and building out, hopefully, a future studio so that I can make more videos like this for all of you. Check them out in the link below, show them some love, and thanks again to Wham Bam. All right, let's get back into the video. So what's my conclusion? For me, personally, I'll definitely be using my Bambu Lab X1 Carbon a lot more in the future. I really love this printer, and I think that with a few software tweaks, it's only going to get better. Plus, as I noted in last week's video, Bambu has been super responsive about actually doing those tweaks and improvements, so I'm optimistic that those are gonna happen sooner rather than later. And while I'm definitely not letting my Voron go anytime soon, I can already feel that the X1C has replaced my Prusa MK3S Plus as my go-to, it just works printer. So let me know in the comments below if you'd be interested in a comparison between any of the printers that I have, such as the Voron or the Sovel SV06, for example, or if you, like me, have pretty much just decided that this is the reigning champion. By the way, I want to take a quick moment to thank my Patreon supporters, new and old, who, among other perks like exclusive discounts to top manufacturers, a weekly newsletter of my top 3D prints, and early ad-free viewing of my videos, have actually known that this video and last week's video were coming for weeks now, and they all managed to keep it a secret. So thanks to all of you for your support and for keeping the cat in the bag so this video would have more of a surprise factor. Thanks as always to all of you for watching, liking, and commenting, subscribing, and all of that, because it really does make a difference. I'll see you in the next one, and happy 3D printing.